So today I'm gonna tell you about the 7 commandments that I always try to follow for great photo walks. And I thought, why not practice what I preach and do a photo walk myself to illustrate these 7 commandments. Commandment 1. You shall snap the first photo immediately. Whenever you enter an IKEA warehouse, you will find not only bags at entrance, but you will also find some irresistibly cheap items, such as a bag of candles for $1. And this is to get you into shopping mode immediately. And in the same way, you want to get into photography mode immediately when you go out for a photo walk. So just take out your camera, take a photo of whatever, even if you don't feel like it's going to be a good photo. This triggers your creativity mindset and your photography mode, and you will immediately try to improve on that first image, and you will be all set for a great photo walk. And you will take a lot of photos that you would otherwise have missed because you weren't in photography mode from the beginning. In the same way that IKEA would have missed a lot of purchases from you if you weren't in shopping mode from the beginning. Commandment 2. You shall bring no other lenses besides the one you pick. The feeling of being weighed down by a lot of heavy equipment is the worst killer of creativity you can have on a photo walk. Try to pack as lightly as humanly possible so that you can walk freely and focus on the photography and not on how heavy your equipment is. I always bring only one lens with me. Commandment 3. You shall introduce a constraint to boost creativity. Whenever you feel like you have no inspiration or creativity, one of the best things to try is to introduce a constraint. Like in my case, I introduced the constraint of only shooting in black and white. And I hate shooting in black and white, and that is a good thing because then I know it's a real constraint for me. I would hate missing all the shots of these wonderful red plants here. But at the same time, I forced myself to discover that black and white photography can actually be very nice and beautiful. For example, in this shot of this snail, the way it melts and merges with the background, I wouldn't have gotten that with a color photograph. And this day when I introduced this constraint, I discovered for the first time the joy of shooting in black and white, something I would never have tried unless I would have forced myself to do it. Try a constraint. Commandment 4. You shall follow the good light. What I mean by this is not just that you should follow light that looks beautiful, but it is kind of the essence of this commandment. What I mean is that you should always follow your gut feeling when it comes to where to go on your photo walk. If you feel like you want to go into that forest, that narrow path that you haven't seen before, you feel like there might be something there that you should photograph, then you must go there. You must follow your intuition. Not because there necessarily exists anything more beautiful in there, you're not a psychic, right? But because if you follow your gut feeling, you will feed your inspiration and creativity. And even if you wouldn't find anything interesting to photograph in there, you would find more creative ways to take photos. And that's what counts in the end. Commandment 5. You shall honor your gut when it says a photo must be taken. This is a commandment that you mostly hear from street photographers, but it of course applies to every kind of photography. Whenever you have a chance to take a shot and you feel in your gut that this would be a great photo, you must never give in to the laziness of not picking up your camera or the fear of embarrassment of taking a photo in an appropriate moment. You just need to take the photograph. This sunset in the forest last summer, it will never come back exactly the same way. This cat on this beach in the Maldives, it will never sit there in exactly the same way in the same lighting conditions. And if it ever will, I won't be there. This foggy morning when I had just purchased my new Samyang lens, it will never come back exactly the same way it was. This flower will never stand here in this forest in exactly the same way again. I actually returned the day after, but it had already started to wither. And this Canada goose, it will never walk here on this beach in exactly the same light in exactly the same way again. So make sure to follow your gut instinct. Whenever you feel you need to take a photograph, take it. Commandment 6. You shall review sharpness and composition before leaving the scene. This is one that I have struggled with a lot before I finally learned it, I hope. Look at a photo and it looks like this in the camera display and you're kind of happy. Nice photo, right? Well, maybe not quite, because when you get home you notice this. It will never hold up for much more than posting on Instagram, because it's blurry and you didn't check closely enough. But this day, of course, I followed my commandment and checked, and I took another photo that came out sharp, because I checked that as well. And this was the final result. A photograph that I would never have gotten unless I had actually checked the sharpness and the composition in my camera very, very closely right after taking the photo. So work in a habit of always checking the composition and sharpness of your photos right at the scene, before you leave the scene, so that you have a chance to retake them if they aren't perfect. This is just one more example of a photograph that I would probably not have gotten unless I had actually checked the first attempt and seen that it was unsharp. And this is another example. So always make sure to check your photos before you leave the scene and you will come home with a lot more nice photographs. Commandment 7. You shall always walk somewhere new. We have already mentioned a few keys to creativity in this video, such as having a constraint and getting into a creative mode right away. Another really great key to creativity is variation. And if you always walk to the same places on your photo walks, you will soon discover that your creativity just withers and dies. So always try to walk somewhere new, or at least have part of your walk be a new place, so that you can get some variation and thus more creativity. And lastly, I have one more commandment for you. See you soon again.